In this video, we are going to write the code for WGAN-GP. I'm connected to L4 GPU, so just connect to whatever GPU is available to you. And let's import first what we need: TensorFlow, NumPy, and Matplotlib. And from the previous video, let's copy some code. I'm going to import my fashion MNIST, and I'm just interested in this Xtran. So let's run. Xtran run, and batch size is going to be 128. Again, I'm adding this one extra dimension for the channel, and rest of the code will remain as it is. I'm going to drop reminder to true so that all batches should have 128 images. The noise shape is going to be 128, and the generator architecture will look something like this. It's very simple. There is nothing new in this architecture. We have dense layers with these number of units without any activation function, then batch normalization, ReLU activation function. So here I have intentionally used this ReLU activations function so that in the exercise you need to change this ReLU to like Riki ReLU or ReLU to see the difference on the generated images. Now let's run it. Let's create an object of generator and pass an image to this generator. So generator, the noise shape is going to be 128. So let's remove this noise shape. We actually don't need it in the generator. I have also removed the noise argument from the generator as well. So I'm creating the object of the generator, then I'm passing a random noise. So instead of using here the static 128, let's use this variable so that in the exercise, if you change this value, our generator will generate images accordingly. Then pass the noise to the generator in order to get the generated image. Print the shape. It is going to be a four-dimensional image, and then just display the height and width pixels. So let's run. And here, as you can see, the shape is 128, the batch dimension, and then 28 by 28, which is height and width, and then 1 means the channel. So in case of RGB images, it will be 3, but since it's a gray image, just black and white pixels, so that's why it's 1. Now let's write the code for Critic. The code for the Critic will be very similar to what we did in the discriminator. Convolutional operation, then leaky ReLU, then again convolutional operation, leaky ReLU, and finally flattening it and passing the input to the dense layer with 1 unit. So this is going to output our score, and again there is no bound on our final score. That's why we have to use that gradient penalty so that we could avoid that sudden jumps in the output. Let's run. Finally, let's combine these two classes, the generator, the critic, into this GAN class, and I'm going to pass my noise to the generator first and then those fake images to the critic in order to get the score for the fake images. I have already created the object of the generator right here, so I don't need to create it again. That's why I'm just creating the object of the critic, putting the trainable to false, and then passing the generator and the critic object to this GAN object. Let's run. This is going to be our Wasserstein loss function. Very simple. We have discussed it in detail in the previous video. This is our utility function, which is going to show us the model performance in terms of its generation ability during the training process. Let's compile our WGAN. So I'm going to use this ADAM optimizer with this learning rate. Beta is going to be this, beta 2 will be this, and the loss is going to be Wasserstein loss. So let's run. I'm going to train the critic for 5 times in each cycle, which is actually the recommended value. Then the lambda is going to be 10, and for the critic, I'm going to use this optimizer with these settings. So this optimizer, which we have defined in this above line, will be used for training generator, because with the help of this W again GP, we will train just the generator. So we need a separate optimizer in order to train the critic, and this is what this optimizer is going to do. Now, in order to make things a bit easy to understand, I have wrote this line of code which will mathematically tell you what is gradient penalty. So it is actually this term, and we are just going to convert this term into TensorFlow code. This is my gradient penalty function. Let's create here the training function now. So this is our critic training step. We have discussed this function in the previous video as well, and I'm not going to explain these lines again. I'll run it directly. Similarly, this is going to be our complete training step. So in this complete training step, first of all, I'm training my critic 5 times and then generator a single time. And this if is bit new, I haven't discussed it in the previous video. All it is doing is to output our score after every 100 steps of training. So this is like giving us information about the model performance. And now let's start the training process. And this is our initial prediction by the model, which is just gibberish. So the training has been completed, and it took almost 2 hours to train. And as you can see, if I go to my first generated image set, it was like this, just noise. And now if I go to like last training set, it looks more meaningful. Yes, here as you can see, this looks like a handbag, then this is like a shoe, this is a shirt, then t-shirt, shoe, this looks like a long shirt maybe, this is another shirt type, and this also looks like a handbag. So these are my predictions, and what I'm thinking is to create a GIF of these predictions. So this is the code which I copied from a website. Let's run it. Now I'm going to read all the images, and let's create the GIF. So it has been created. Where it is. Let's see the GIF. Yeah, it seems pretty good. As you can see, with each epoch, our model is improving bit by bit. And this is the last one. So I hope you have understood how to implement this WGAN. And in the next video, we are going to learn another important architecture. And I'll see you there. Bye bye.